A crown is an ornament worn on the head, symbolizing authority, legitimacy, tradition, or victory. A crown is a traditional form of head ornament worn by monarchs as a symbol of their power and dignity. A crown is often, by extension, a symbol of the monarch's government or items endorsed by it. Hallelujah, glory to Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, praise Master Jesus. Welcome, my brother and sister. This is Promised Land Proclamations with Daughter of Judah, with declarations from Mount Zion, titled Crowned with Dominion. Hallelujah, glory to Jesus Christ. Dominion is sovereignty. It is control. Sovereignty is supreme power and supreme authority. Supreme power is the highest level of authority. Authority is the power, the right to give orders, make decisions, and enforce obedience. True authority is the power and the right to direct and control someone or something. All power and authority rests with Jesus Christ alone and has been granted to the children of the Most High God through the blood of Jesus by the power of the Holy Spirit, His Ruach HaKodesh. By His divine power, He has given us unto us all things that pertain to life and godliness through the knowledge of Him that hath called us to glory and virtue. Through Christ we have exceeding great and precious promises, that by these we might be partakers of the divine nature, having escaped the corruption that is in the world through lust. Giving diligence, you have added to your faith virtue, and to virtue knowledge, and to knowledge you have added temperance, and to temperance patience, and to patience, godliness. To godliness, you have added brotherly kindness, and to brotherly kindness, charity. You, my crowned children, are crowned with dominion. You have entered a season of rest and restoration. It is a reward for your willingness to obey me, a Kyrie eleison blessing, a gift given by the mercy of God. You are crowned and anointed. On your royal crown are nine spires, which symbolize the fruit of my Holy Spirit: love, joy, peace, forbearance, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control, my Holy Spirit, which you carry. Seated above the band are three prominent stones, symbolizing Father, Son, Holy Spirit, the authority in which you are crowned. The seven jewels on the band are the sevenfold gifts of the Holy Spirit: wisdom, understanding, counsel, fortitude, knowledge, piety, and fear of the Lord, endowed to you. Seven is the number of completion, fullness. You are complete and full in me, a chosen generation, a holy nation, a peculiar people. You show forth the praises of Him who called you out of darkness into His marvelous light. You, my beloved, are crowned with dominion and shall soon take your rightful place in the stars. You have remained steadfast in your trial, and I have used those trials to strengthen your neck to carry your crown. I have placed it on your head myself. Enter ye into your rest. This, my brother and sister, was dictated to me from the Father, and He's asked me to play this song.
This goes for a massive celebration. Welcome to the winner's circle. We all winning here. 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 We all winning here.
Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus Christ. Welcome, my brother and sister, to the winner circle. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise Master Jesus. I'm just so excited about this word. So excited. Hallelujah, hallelujah. But the saints of the Most High shall take the kingdom and possess the kingdom forever, even forever and ever. Hallelujah, glory to Jesus Christ. And so the Father said to us all, I charge thee therefore before God and the Lord Jesus Christ, who shall judge the quick and the dead at his appearing and his kingdom. Preach the word, be instant in season, out of season, reprove, rebuke, exhort with all long suffering and doctrine, for the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lusts shall they heap to themselves teachers having itching ears, and they shall turn away their ears from the truth, and shall be turned unto fables. But watch thou in all things, endure afflictions, do the work of an evangelist, make full proof of thy ministry. And so it is with that admonition in mind that I present here unto you, my sister and brother, as a living witness and testament, as a recipient of the Kyrie eleison blessing mentioned above in the word. Hallelujah, glory to Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Welcome, my brother and sister. The Father has given me this word and put it together in a very specific manner, and it has a lot of moving parts and pieces, so the Holy Spirit is helping me out. This Kyrie eleison blessing is a blessing of mercy, as its title states. So Kyrie eleison means the Lord's mercy. Mercy is compassion or forgiveness shown towards someone whom it is within one's power to punish or harm. Though nothing I have done or will ever do can merit this blessing, because it is given simply by the mercy of God. Just as he said to Moses, I will have mercy on whom I will have mercy, and I will have compassion on whom I will have compassion. One thing I know about God is that if he gives you something, you can bet he wants you to use it to bless others. Hallelujah, glory to Jesus Christ. He wants you to use it in whatever way you can, trusting him to increase it over his people. With that said, I loose the spirit of mercy, the spirit of Kyrie eleison, over the nations, over the world, and over you, dear listener. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, my brother, my sister. I'm so excited about this word, and I'm so excited about being able to loose this spirit of Kyrie eleison, which is a spirit of mercy, just God's mercy. It's through his mercy to his people. He decides who he's going to have mercy on, and he's in the season of pouring out his spirit. Hallelujah. And these last few years have been wrought with much for the deliverance of God's people. We all know that we've been through so much strife and struggle, and it's been for this crowning to train us. And so the Father's asked me to read a word to you. My name is Daughter of Judah, and I submit unto you my tent peg. Hallelujah, glory to Jesus Christ. This is from my journals titled Codex, Breaking the Zeitgeist of Our Collective Generation. The enchanting spirit of despair, depression, brokenness, and disruption of destiny are the collective zeitgeist of our age. The problem with a broken spirit is this. You can live with a broken spirit. It is possible. However, it is an excruciatingly painful existence, and it is not recommended. While some hearts do heal with time and others are mended by the great physician in his time, it is true that some hearts are indeed left broken. God does not heal all wounds, nor does he mend all broken hearts. In every experience, there is a message, and the message of a broken heart is that God is waiting for us to learn the lesson of believing what he has said to us in his holy word, and to apply the lesson of speaking life over our own selves, preaching to the dry spaces and dry bones down inside oneself. A broken spirit is a pained and grieved spirit, and it is the response to hate, anger, and ingratitude. Depression or brokenness is God revealing your heart to your own self with the goal of restoration. Hallelujah, glory to Jesus Christ. Excuse me. A broken heart is the ultimate lesson of belief, believing him when he says he is close to the brokenhearted. The spiritually dead are unable to reconcile themselves to the word of God, so they remain in unrest. But you are not so. It is Jesus Christ that reconciles man unto God the Father, and it is by him we receive knowledge, wisdom, understanding, fortitude, and true healing. Surrendering to Jesus comes with a promise of restoration. Within restoration, there is understanding. Wisdom shows us that God is the head and not the tail, and that his thoughts are higher than ours. Truly believing God is close to the brokenhearted should cause a rejoicing, a longing for us all to embrace it. Dominion is sovereignty, is control, is supreme power. Supreme authority is the highest level of authority and has been given to you concerning your own everlasting soul. You yourself have dominion over your own self, and as caretaker of your own soul, you rule supreme over your destiny. More easily said than done, but entirely possible, is the ability to accept the awareness of dominion over one's own thoughts, feelings, impressions, and choices. Taking dominion of the territory of one's own mind is the greatest battlefield of life and is won by the weapon of surrender. Each is given a choice to believe God by faith, which is represented in surrender. Surrender shifts things. It shifts you to dominion. Alignment of spirit, thought, word, and deed in full surrender to God's word is the secret place of power. No devil in hell can snatch you from dwelling in the presence of the Most High God. The zeitgeist of brokenness cannot locate you in the secret place. Full surrender to the word of God is where true power is. True supreme authority. The collective zeitgeist of this age is under the feet of the children of the Most High, just as he promised. His children carry the spirit of wisdom, aligning themselves with the Lord of hosts who fights for them. Crowned with dominion, entered into his rest. Hallelujah, glory to Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
And lows. We all know life gets tough when you're by yourself. It's a lonely road. If you ever need someone, stop crying around and call my phone. And I'll be there.
Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus Christ. A reminder from the Father that he will be there, and he will even loan us his heart if our heart gets broken. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus Christ. I'm just so in love with this word. It's a beautiful word. And so, as directed by the Father, I will give you the next section of this word, crowned with dominion. And this is just a word coming to you from my journals as well, but a word I was given by the Father. Imagine that the universe has been conspiring for you, working in your favor, And your biggest losses end up being your wins, and even your small wins end up being bigger wins in the end. As though everything has been planned and jointly fitted together to restore you. As though it was all meant for your good, to restore you unto the great I am. Imagine, if you will, that he has redeemed you unto himself, and he has done it through your time here on earth, which he created for that very purpose. Imagine with me, if you will. Hallelujah. An angel of the Lord once told me, "Don't be in such a hurry. The race is not to the swift. Time and chance happen for all." He gave all them that believe, that believe the power to become sons of God. Do not doubt what the Lord God has said. It will be heard of you that there was rain in your home, showers of blessings on you. Only believe by faith. The blood of Jesus speaks for you. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. My brother, my sister, I want to take a moment and to talk with you about how God used my broken heart. And I wanted to testify and glorify to him that the surrendering to my broken heart was a key to dominion within my own self. Hallelujah. And it wasn't until I actually surrendered to the word, there was for a long time that I felt like I had continued with a broken heart due to life circumstance. And so many of God's people have surrendered to that spirit of, and it's a zeitgeist, it's the spirit of the age, right? Everyone has had this cast at them, despair, depression, brokenness. And of course, depression truly is God's calling you out to sit with him because he wants to reveal the things of your heart. And the world has tried to convince people that they are to remain in despair and depression and brokenness. But of course, that's because it's the spirit of the age. Because the enemy, that is the enemy of your soul, does not want God's children to stand and rise. Remember, the scriptures say that all of the earth groans for the earnest manifestation of the sons of God. Hallelujah. For us to come into the fulfillment and walk in our identity in Christ. And so it is with a broken heart that I surrendered to the Father. Finally, I surrendered it. I continued for years to ask him to heal my broken heart. And I was asking the wrong question. I wasn't even asking any questions, to tell you the truth. I was pretty much just demanding that the Father heal my heart, rather than receiving what he had already said, which is, I've given you everything that you need. I'm close to the brokenhearted. I don't despise those of a contrite heart, right? I'm close to them. So instead of asking him what he wanted me to learn in that season, I remained in a broken place for a lot of years. And that's due in combination two things. One, that is the spirit that's being cast out into the universe, the spirit of brokenness. And the other reason is, and part of that reason is because the Kyrie eleison spirit had not been released, the spirit of mercy that God was casting over the earth, pouring out his spirit to release his children from the spirit of despair and depression through the wisdom and knowledge, spirit of the wisdom, through the revelation of this zeitgeist working against them. And the other reason is because I had surrendered to the idea that I needed God to heal me, that I was not in the exact place he needed me to be. So as I finally said to him, okay, well, this is as good as it gets. And if I'm going to be, you know, have a broken heart, I'm still going to testify about your goodness. I'm still going to glorify your holy name. And I'm still going to talk about your mercy that you've displayed throughout my life, despite all the other things that had happened. And so I tell you, my brother, my sister, the key is surrendering whatever it is you think, the way you think it should be. And we learn this throughout our lifetime. As God shows us, you know, sometimes there is a song, I believe it says, "Thank God for unanswered prayers." And I'm so grateful for that, because had God answered the prayer to heal my heart, remember I stated to you that he's close to the brokenhearted and he was using it for a purpose. And one of the most beautiful things that you can get from a broken heart is you learn compassion. And it's drinking from the cup, the same cup that our Lord and Savior drank from in the garden, right? It's broken, just feeling, you know, so forsaken by his friends, even feeling that way by his father, like everyone had turned from him. And so that is when God is closest to us, and that is when it is easiest for us to hear his voice. And of course, he promises to never leave us and forsake us, but it's such a beautiful thing the way he allows a broken heart. And when we change our mind and say, okay, I'm going to surrender this broken heart, and I'm going to put it on the altar for you. And at the surrender of that, slowly God opened my eyes to all the beauty and mercy that he had placed in my life, all the times that he had covered me, all the times he had covered my husband and myself in the blood. You know, the blood of Jesus speaks better things, right, than the blood of Abel. The blood of Jesus speaks for his children. And the devil has tried to lie to tell God's children that this has been a race, and that there is a race, but it's only going to go to the swiftest or the fastest or the strongest. But that's not true. The Bible says that time and chance happen for all, right? And he gave to all of them that believe, he gave them the power to become sons of God. Hallelujah, glory to Jesus Christ. Do not doubt what the Lord God has said. That's what he says. It will be heard of you that there was rain in your home and that there were showers of blessings on you. Only believe by faith, because the blood of Jesus speaks for you. And as we surrender the way we think it should look, or the circumstances of our life, or all of it, as we surrender even the broken heart, because really the broken heart is being out of alignment with God. It's when you're distuned. It's when you're distuned to what he has already laid out for you, right? So alignment of spirit, thought, word, and deed in full surrender to God's word is the secret place of power. That's where you take dominion, and you must have dominion over your heart and your mind first. Dominion over and understanding. And of course, these things are given by the power of the Holy Spirit, the power of the Holy Spirit. And by the brokenness is where God was teaching me, I'm going to give you a heart of flesh. And God loves to work with broken things. May I say, he just loves broken things. He doesn't like to take things that are perfect. He likes to take broken things and use them. Hallelujah. And he's the Lord of hosts, so he fights for his children. And his children carry, right, the spirit of wisdom. We have the spirit of wisdom that's given unto us, the Holy Spirit. And so the Holy Spirit is what helps us to align ourselves with the Lord of hosts, who's actually fighting for us. And this is how we're crowned with dominion and we enter into his rest. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus Christ. And so Father is asking that you'll only believe, and that you will only believe and imagine that everything has been working to your good. And if you'll ask by the power of the Holy Spirit, if you will surrender anything else that you have in your heart, even if it's a broken heart, even if it's despair, because that's the word is surrounded around that. There's just one small thing, maybe one small hurt, and it's caused you to throw yourself in despair because you've spoken it over yourself. Thank you, Holy Spirit. There's so many times we say, I'm so depressed, or I'm in despair, or I'm frustrated, or I'm angry, or I'm upset. But remember that when we align ourselves with the word of God, that's in full surrender, that's the secret place of power. Then the enemy cannot touch you. No devil in hell can snatch you from dwelling there. And so it's the enemy's goal to get us out of position, to get us to think that we are in despair, to get us to think that we are depressed. And of course, heard a video at some point and it said that depression was deep rest. And I can really, really, really speak to that, because in the season that God revealed this about this spirit of attack that had been on his people, and it's a spirit of the age. It's literally a spirit of the age. It goes across socioeconomic classes. It goes across the nations in the world, right? This spirit of despair, depression, brokenness, disruption of destiny. You know, so much in the word, it says, you know, I've created you for a special purpose. Call unto me, and I'll show you great and mighty things, right? And then he says again in Jeremiah, I have plans to prosper you and not harm you, right? To give you hope. So there's these things spoken over God's children. And for so long, this zeitgeist has allowed for us to believe that we should remain in that broken place, or we should remain in despair. And so depression is a deep rest where you pull back from everything. And it's because God wants us to rest, deeply rest with him, and come away from this character or this idea or this impression that the world, the spirit that's being pushed on you. Because as I surrendered that to the Father, he began to reveal to me and just show me all the mighty things in my life. You know, hallelujah, glory to Jesus Christ. My husband and I could have been killed that night of the beautiful tragedy that happened in my life. My husband could have been killed, and I could still be alive and alone without him. I wouldn't have been able to, I'm so grateful, because also the mission trip that came after that, you know, the Father called my husband and myself to Montana. And had it not been for a broken heart, I would not have been able to hear the call, because the Bible says God's close to the brokenhearted. So when you're sitting close to someone, you can hear them more clearly, right, than more far away. So hallelujah. The healing of my son, the healing of myself, the healing of my husband, restoration, full restoration, and in having every lie of the enemy removed, even power and dominion and authority over this zeitgeist of depression that we claim over ourselves. So remember that we're called to speak life into our dry bones and not call up bad things about ourselves, to not, you know, partner with the spirit of depression. But of course, if you're depressed, you may not even said you're depressed. You're just in it. But of course, what we can change our mind, we can have a mind reset and understand that brokenness, depression, despair, those things, this is God. God is close to those people. He's close to you in that. So it is something that should make everybody want to say, well, I want to have a bout of depression. And many times, especially in this nation, this is a nation of medication, we try to medicate people away from that, but it just makes the process longer. Because depression and despair and brokenness truly is when you're far from the Father, and your spirit knows it. So your spirit feels broken and in despair, and as we come back. And so this Kyrie eleison blessing actually is being poured out over the nations for those also that are not even aware or don't even have any idea how to come up out of despair and depression. And of course, that was my case. I had so many things to be excited about, new ideas, new business ventures, kingdom partners, kingdom people that God had sent into our life, into the lives of our children, and into our ministry, different projects he had me working on. All of it was just so many things to be excited about. Where we had moved, we are just we love it. It's beautiful. New friendships. I have a new friend that is like she is a sister, and just so many beautiful things that God had been pouring out on me. So as I surrendered the broken heart and said, okay, well, I believe you. I believe you, Father, that you want me to have a broken heart. It was in that moment that he began. It caused a breaking of the enemy's lies. Thank you, Holy Spirit. It caused it to break. And suddenly dominion came in, because the Holy Spirit got me to understand, you know, by faith, you're believing that my word says that I'm close to you, and I am close to you, and because you believe by faith, so it is unto you. Hallelujah, glory to Jesus Christ. And so I've been called to come and speak this word, speak against this zeitgeist, teach on this zeitgeist, and help my brothers and sisters to understand how being crowned with dominion relates to surrender. When we surrender to Jesus Christ, because Jesus Christ is the authority over all things in the world. He is the master authority of all things. And so by the power of the Holy Spirit, God has crowned his children with dominion, because we're being prepared for a time and season, right? We know that we're being prepared for this time and season that is upon us. And if you know, you know. Hallelujah, glory to Jesus Christ. And so I wanted to glorify the Father about a broken heart. There's no way, and I can confess this by my tongue, but there's no way I could have learned everything that I needed to know to fill my lamp with oil, except for the broken heart, which caused many, many tears, but it caused God to stay close to me. It was not through enough of my own work, so it doesn't mean I could have read the Bible enough or studied enough or prayed enough. It is truly through his mercy, because I know I didn't do enough. I know so many times I laid down the middle floor and cried and gave up and just was so mad about, for years, I did not want to have a broken heart. And I complained and complained and complained about it, never thinking to ask the Father, what are you wanting me to learn in this experience of a broken heart? But hallelujah, glory to Jesus Christ, through enough testifying, ministering services, and enough prophetic words, it was given to me to understand to ask that question. So there is even not any worry of having to ask the right question, because the Holy Spirit gave it to me to understand, to ask the Father, what is it you want me to learn in this lesson and through this brokenness? And what he wanted me to understand was, one, that he breaks up the ground of our heart so that he can plant good seeds there, right, and they can grow good things. Also, that throughout my life, especially the years prior to this beautiful tragedy and God doing this work in my life, I was a tree of God's, but I wasn't bearing any fruit. And so he had pruned back, you know, broken up the ground like you would with a tree. And this was this other, this was this extra chance to bear more fruit. And it was also a blessing of God. God was doing it. All of it was through his power, his might. I had completely surrendered. So I know that this Kyrie eleison blessing is just a gift of mercy. One, I did not deserve. So many times I complained and was frustrated and gave over to so many spirits as opposed to asking the all-important question, what is it you want me to learn in this, Father? Hallelujah, glory to Jesus Christ. So my brother, my sister, hallelujah, glory to Jesus Christ, I'm so excited for you. Let me be the first to congratulate you that you've been crowned with dominion. Should a brother or sister come across this word and you are desiring to be crowned with dominion, may I suggest that you give everything to God on the altar, surrender it all, and receive Jesus Christ? Because it is only by the power of the Holy Spirit through the Ruach HaKodesh that we can be crowned with dominion. It is the power of the Holy Spirit that gives us power over our thoughts, over our impressions, our decisions, our feelings. A lot of people like to be in their feelings, but feelings are dangerous. Hallelujah, glory to Jesus Christ. So the scriptures will be in the description box, as well as the word that the Father has given to his children. You'll note on the screen that there is an actual photograph of a crown. And this is actually just a pencil drawing. And may I say that the Father first showed me this crown with dominion and what it meant with the three large precious stones, the seven diadems around the band, and then also the spires. And at the time, I drew it in my journal, and I'm no artist, let me say, hallelujah. And I said to the Father, well, you're going to have to provide a picture for that because I don't really have, you know, a way to kind of clip videos together. I do understand how it's done, but this I just really don't have the technology to do that with me. And so would you believe, and of course you would, my brother, my sister, that immediately when I went to go look for a crown to make this video and to title it, right away on the first page was this crown. And that's the exact one I was shown in my spirit. And it was even shown with the pencil drawing. So he already knew beforehand. He goes beforehand to make a way for us, right? And so the Father has sent me to testify, and I'm here because I want to testify that you don't need to despair over a broken heart or brokenness or any of the spirit of this age, because the Father is pouring out a Kyrie eleison blessing, a gift of mercy to heal his children. He is doing this because this is a process and a season of restoration. And he knows that it's so much, there's been so much, right? There's been so much with the body of Christ. So much has happened that he knows it cannot happen by our power or might to fully surrender. It happens just by the power of God. So we just only need to ask the Holy Spirit to help us surrender anything that we're holding on to. And so I'm very honored and humbled and grateful to bring this word to you. My brother and my sister, I'm very excited. Let me be the first to congratulate you. Hallelujah. It's such a beautiful thing to enter dominion and have this authority over your own self and to be at peace, because this is where you enter into the rest, enter into his rest. And it's amazing, beautiful. It really is a miracle. I will state that for my own self. I am the miracle. So many times I wanted to give up. So many times I was such in despair. So many times other people mocked and laughed. You know, that's one of the things that God really had to heal me from, was it came back to me that many people were laughing and mocking that my daughter had been murdered and that my son was in prison for life. And this really just, this caused some severe brokenness, right? Because I just couldn't believe. And of course, as God's people, God has given us a tender heart. And so when the real ugly of the world comes at us, it can be quite detrimental to our spirit. But the truth is that God used that place to give me a heart for his people and to show how broken they were to even want to project that kind of thing on anybody else. And so hallelujah, glory to Jesus Christ. I also want to state to you, my brother, my sister, crowned with dominion, this group of people that you've been crowned with dominion, you are the miracle. You may have been kind of looking around for a miracle, and you are going to have miracles bestowed upon you. Remember, it says, let it be heard. It will be heard of you. This is what the Holy Spirit says. It will be heard of you that there's been a rain in your home, that there's been these blessings, right? All these blessings have poured out. And so you've been crowned with dominion first over your own heart, own self. You've made the best choice you could ever make by receiving Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. And of course, you've received the sevenfold gifts of the Holy Spirit. And then you have the fruit of the Holy Spirit. And you've been crowned with dominion. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus Christ. And so may I finish with this. This is the song the Father would like for me to finish with. And in the description box, I will have the whole playlist that he gave for this particular word. There are several songs on there. It's got the sounds of shofar, which is a Lion of Judah warfare sound. It has Zion from Aaron Schuster, Winner's Circle, Highs and Lows, Waterloo, Make Your Own Kind of Music with Karen Carpenter. Oh, no, that's with Mama Cass. And he has the five stair steps from Oh Child, Bellamy Brothers, Let Your Love Flow, Harry Belafonte, Jump in the Line, And then he's got Iko Iko, my bestie. You'll know that song. Worthy is the Lamb. You're still the one. And Before I Go. And he has placed them in order and asked that his children would give a listen to this playlist. So I will put a link in the description box as well. Congratulations, my brother and my sister. You have learned how to make your own kind of music. You've learned how to sing your own kind of song. I love that song. It says you're going to be nowhere, the loneliest time of your life. Hallelujah. That is the wilderness. This is where we learn to discern the sound of our Father's voice. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And so, this is my own song. This is me making my music, singing my own song about the goodness of God, about his many blessings, about his mercy, about his tenderness, about the tears that he counts. So many times I had been told in the scriptures and by others that God had a jar for our tears and that he stored them and that they were prayers. I didn't know if I could understand that or believe it, but I asked the Holy Spirit to help me believe it, and he did. Hallelujah, glory to Jesus Christ. I know that no tear that's ever fallen from your eyes has not been gathered by the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Hallelujah. I give you glory, my King. This is my song, brother and sister. My name is Daughter of Judah, and I've been crowned with dominion, and I've been called forth to the nations to release the Kyrie Eleison blessing. And before I go, may I say I bless you. In the name of Jesus Christ, may I say I cancel the plans of the enemy over your life. Hallelujah, glory to Jesus Christ. By the power vested in me, by the power of the Holy Spirit of the living God, the great I am, I loose the spirit of Kyrie Eleison over the nations, over the children of the Most High God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, glory to Jesus Christ. You are crowned with dominion, my brother, my sister. Receive it. The Father has placed your crown himself. He has straightened it. Your challenges, the things you've been through, the struggles, the whole thing, the storyline of your life was used to strengthen your neck to hold this crown. Hallelujah, and you will be used by the Father in the greatest harvest ever known to mankind. And then someday, hallelujah, soon, you will cast this crown at the feet of our beautiful Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, where every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Father is saying, just call my name and I'll be there. Hallelujah. I bless you in the name of Jesus Christ, my brother, my sister. May you have a wonderful rest of your day. So excited to see each one of you at the wedding supper of the Lamb. And I'm also very excited to see these crowns cast at the feet of our beautiful Lord and Savior. Thank you, Abba Yah. Thank you, Father God, for all that you've done and all that you will do. Increase our strength, Father God, as we begin to work the greatest harvest ever known to mankind, crowned with dominion. This has been Promised Land Proclamations with your sister, daughter of Judah. Good evening.